sim control, we're ready to go to run. Thank you.
Well, Jim, it looks like the GPS residual's down. They ought to be calling us here any minute.
Yeah, I agree. It's looking pretty good. Probably just waiting on C-band tracking.
Discovery, take GPS.
Copy, take GPS.
All right, looks like it took.
Yep.
Well, Jim, you ready to get some lunch? That was a great run.
Yeah, I agree. Let's do it.
All right. And we can find that new restaurant.
Navigation is the science of following a planned path from one point to another. This includes using a GPS or global positioning system to navigate your car to a destination, guide a hiker through the woods, or help first responders locate you in an emergency. GPS is also used by financial institutions to timestamp transactions, like the swipe of a credit card or a cash withdrawal from an ATM. Accurate timing is also necessary to support critical applications in space, such as NASA's communication and tracking networks. NASA's Small Business Innovation and Research, or SBIR program, supports the development of technologies that benefit NASA, encourages private sector commercialization of innovations, and in turn provides spin-offs that improve our lives every day.
SBIR program is very important to developing technology for NASA, as it insulates NASA programs from the risks associated with the far-reaching technology development. It also gives NASA access to the efficiencies and the capabilities of small businesses.
The Small Business Innovative Research Program develops technologies in three phases. In phase one, a six-month conceptual study is performed to determine feasibility of the idea. In phase two, a two-year hardware development or software development is undertaken. At the end of that time, a prototype is delivered for NASA. Phase three is when the prototype is incorporated or adopted by an internal NASA program or by a large American business for further development.
Most U.S. rocket launches take place along the U.S. Eastern Launch Range at either Kennedy Space Center or Cape Canaveral Air Force Base. In the event of a failure, the NASA range flight safety systems provide a means to prevent that launcher from reaching populated areas. As part of the effort to improve safety during launches, NASA is developing a system that uses global positioning system receivers placed directly on board the launch vehicle to track its trajectory during ascent.
The SBIR program allows us to help guide outside expertise in exploring fundamental problems and interests that NASA has. We're looking at ways to mitigate possible interference of the GPS signals on a launch vehicle, using commercial GPS receivers. So it usually involves antenna technology to look at multiple satellites and compare different signals and be able to cancel out any potential interference.
The SBIR program funds a number of initiatives that support navigation from the time of launch throughout interplanetary transfer. These initiatives may one day help navigate spacecraft in deep space using X-ray and gamma-ray pulsar-based navigation. Pulsars are rapidly spinning stars which broadcast a repeating signal. They are, in fact, lighthouses in the cosmos that can be used to help spacecraft navigate through space.
We do have a success to talk about through the SBIR program, and that is with X-ray navigation. We have developed a catalog of pulsars that are good for our purposes. And we've also developed first generation algorithms to analyze the data. We are in the process of building instruments for X-ray navigation, one to fly on the space station and perhaps elsewhere. One area where we have a gap in our knowledge is in onboard autonomous navigation. So we want to have pinpoint landings on various objects. And when the round trip light time becomes prohibitive, you want onboard autonomous nav, and that's an area of focus that we would like to delve into more.
The SBIR also funds a number of technologies that support navigation once we reach the surface of other planets.
There have been a number of successes in the SBIR subtopic for planetary surface navigation. In particular, there's been a phase two effort that's developed a GPS-like capability that for surface planetary navigation position fixing that operates over ranges between 1 and say 10 kilometers. Here we have an example of a piece of hardware that could be deployed on a suit or perhaps a vehicle, and would also be deployed on fixed nodes on towers. This was developed as part of the phase two and delivered to us. There's also been successes in the areas of celestial navigation for planetary surface navigation, as well as Bayesian filtering for surface navigation.
The development of these cutting-edge mission-critical technologies not only help us navigate our way through deep space, they help us get to where we're going right here on Earth.
I guess it's left. I'm not an expert on GPSs, but
it looks like, Jim, we've arrived.
Yeah, this place looks incredibly good. Well, that was some of the best driving I've ever seen, Bob. That was,
not quite as good as your flying of the space shuttle, but I try to do my best.
So whether you swipe your ATM card, make a call on your cell phone, or try to find your way to a new restaurant, many of the advancements in communication and navigation technologies that we enjoy today started with technology developed in partnership with NASA.